enterprise structure, and then we will see what are the changes compared to SAP ECC. Okay, so I already gave you some information regarding SAP Fiori yesterday. So I told you, when you connect on to this particular server, you have two options. You can either connect via this traditional GUI. This is called as traditional GUI. Okay, and the other option is that you can connect it via SAP Fiori. And I also told you that when it comes to configuration, configuration will be still maintained from SPRO. Configuration will be still maintained from SPRO, because in on-premise system, we don't have corresponding SAP Fiori apps for maintaining the configuration. Or instead of saying we don't have, it will be better if we say not all the configurations can be done from SAP Fiori. So as of now, some of the configurations can be done by Fiori, and some of the configurations we still need to follow the normal traditional SPRO screen. Okay, so in today's session, I'll be just using SPRO, and maybe later on, I'll be also showing you which configurations are possible via SAP Fiori also. Okay, so I'll simply go and enter the user ID and password. As I told you, if you are coming from the ECC background, and if you already have user ID and password available into your system, same user ID and password will work. Okay, so no need of any change here. Okay, so once you are in traditional GUI, most of the things are similar. So you will go to SPRO screen. Now within SPRO, you will definitely see some changes. Okay, so for example, this migration to SAP S/4HANA Finance. As the name itself suggests, this is coming from SAP S/4HANA only. When you go to ECC, definitely you will not be able to see this, right? This is one straightforward thing that you can see, which is new in SAP S/4HANA. But other things also, like if you go to financial accounting, I'm not saying the complete folder will be changed, but within the folder, if you talk about the activities, you will find a lot of changes in the activities also. Okay, so that is exactly what we need to discuss. We'll start with the enterprise structure. So the first thing regarding enterprise structure, in terms of setting up the company code, setting up the business areas, functional areas, and all those things, even the chart of accounts and all, there are not much of changes. Okay, enterprise structure, if we talk about creation of organizational elements, there are not much of changes. So what I'll do is I'll quickly just create a company code and some of the basic structure, which we can use to configure the additional scenarios. Okay, so what we normally follow, we go to definition. We can directly go to financial accounting, and within financial accounting, we directly create a legal entity, which is company code. Okay, and I hope all of you are coming from FICO background with good experience. Anyone who wants me to explain the difference between company and company code, I think you already know, right? So the people, Vikram and Dipen, who are attending the classroom session, they are already aware of this. What about Majo, do you want me to explain the difference between company and company code, or maybe Suresh, if you have any question on this?
No.
Yeah, the basics, and that is fine. That's fine,
right? Okay. Yeah, so I will directly go and create the company code. Okay, so at any point of time, if you think that some things of which you need the clarification in terms of ECC also, you can ask that question definitely. Okay, so I'll click on new entry because I'm creating a completely new organizational structure here. Okay, so let's call this company as SFIN. I hope it is not already available. If it is available, then we may need to change it to something else. Yeah, it is not there. So SFIN is the company code that we will use. Whatever scenarios I will show you, I'll keep this company code throughout the course. Okay, so this is Simple Finance as a training company code, just a description which I want to give. Okay, so in the traditional way, you need to provide the city, country, currency, and language. okay, all those same options that we were providing earlier. So let's say city is Mumbai, country is IN, currency is INR, and finally language I'm keeping it as EN, which is nothing but English. Sorry. Okay, and when I try to save this, it will again ask me for the address information, which is again same as ECC. Okay, so I'll just say company, whatever name I want to provide. So I'm just maintaining the same code now as SPIN, and I'm only maintaining the mandatory fields. Since you already know about all these fields, there is no explanation required. So I'll just click on country and save this entity. Okay, so it is asking for transport request. I already had a transport request. We can just use this. Okay, so no change in the way how you maintain the company code. What is next? If I follow the enterprise structure, let me close this. Okay, business area, functional area, as even in ECC, they were optional. So I'm not creating as of now. Maybe when we'll talk about some scenarios, we can create those organizational elements later on. Okay, and controlling, I think it is better to create controlling here itself, because otherwise, once we proceed with our transactions, then it will be difficult to come again and create the controlling area. Okay, so I'm creating the controlling area also. I'll go to this transaction maintain controlling area. Okay, these are just the warning messages, but why exactly they are coming? What is the purpose of that? How to go and check what is wrong? How to rectify that? This will be part of our two or three sessions. We'll be concentrating on this. Okay, so I'll just click on OK and click on new entries to create a new controlling area. Again, I will provide the same code in order to avoid any confusion. Okay, so which means if you have same name throughout, it will be easier for us to remember. Okay, and to keep things simple, I'm saying controlling area same as company code. So no cross company code controlling. Cross company code controlling means if you have multiple company codes and you want one single controlling area to be assigned to all those company codes, then you go for cross company code controlling. Controlling area same as company code means one-to-one relation. Okay, so I'll go for one-to-one relation. Currency type, if I select same as company code, by default, the currency type will be company code currency. Okay, so you just select company code currency here. Automatically, system will copy some of the basic information from company code. Like we defined currency as INR. Okay, chart of accounts, we are still not assigned. So anyways, it will not allow us to proceed. Why? Because all these things must be in place before you create a controlling area. Okay, so maybe I can come out of this, because till the time I'm not assigning all these characteristics, it will not allow me to proceed. Okay, so let's close this. Now, in order for me to assign the chart of account, fiscal year variant, I'll go with the normal flow, which means I will come out of this enterprise structure, go to financial accounting new. Okay, and within the financial accounting global settings, you can see there are these different things. Okay, but again, before I go there, some of the basic things which I want to assign, one is fiscal year variant, second is chart of account. Okay, so those things I will assign it first. So let me go with the chart of accounts first of all. So I'll go for general ledger accounting new. Master data, GL accounts, preparation, edit chart of account list, right? This is the This is where we create the chart of account in SAP. Okay, now if I click on new entry, and again, I'm just providing this as FIN, and this is nothing but COA, chart of account for SFIN. Okay, and here you provide the maintenance language, the language in which you are going to maintain your GL accounts. Length of GL account number, any idea what is the maximum length that you can have? 10 characters, right? Even this is a question which comes in the certification exam also in SAP ECC. And even they ask this question in SAP S/4HANA also. So there is no change. The maximum length of the GL account cannot be more than 10 characters. Okay, so you need to decide whether you want to keep 2, 3, 4, whatever it is. So the best practice which I have seen is 6 characters. Okay, but again, it depends upon company to company. So let's say I'll follow this 4 characters. I don't have much of GL accounts that I'm going to create here. So I'll go for 4. Group chart of account, I think as of now, we don't need to complicate our scenario. So I will keep this as it is. I'm not touching this as of now. Can you tell me one more thing which was available here in SAP ECC, which is not visible now? Anyone? Do you remember any more field available here when you create a chart of account in SAP ECC?
That cost element something.
Yes, exactly. Maju is right. There was a field called as cost element creation, whether it is manual or automatic. Okay, I'll just try if I am able to access this ECC. In the morning, it was giving me some problem, but let's see. Sorry, what is the transaction code for that chart of account? You remember the chart of account transaction code, or maybe I'll follow the SPRO note. No problem.
OB13.
OB?
OB13. 13.
OB13. Okay.
OB.
Yeah. Okay. So this is the list of chart of account. If I double click here, this is what I'm talking about, controlling integration. Okay, so in SAP S/4HANA, we maintain the maintenance language, we maintain the length of GL account number. We also seen there was option for group chart of account and status blocked, but this field was not available in SAP S/4HANA. Yeah, I'm talking about this. Okay, so why this field is not available? First of all, what is the purpose of this field? Okay, so as we know, FI and CO, these are two different components within FICO. Okay, and what is happening currently in today ECC system is the master data for FI is GL account. So whenever you are posting anything in FI, you post into GL accounts. But whenever you are posting anything in controlling, it is via the cost elements. Okay, so normally what postings you do in controlling, it is not balance sheet postings. It is normally profit and loss accounts. So whenever you create any profit and loss GL account, if you want that GL account also should get posted in controlling, then there should be one-to-one relation between GL account and cost element. Okay, so this setting, what we maintain here is there are two options, manual creation or automatic creation, which means as soon as you create a GL account, expense GL account, for example, automatically in the background system will create corresponding cost element also. If you keep it as manual, then if you are aware, if you go to transaction FS00, okay, so let's say for example, if I go for, there are not much, yeah, consumption account is okay. So here there was this button, edit cost element. Okay, what does this mean is, this mean when you create any GL account, if you want to create corresponding cost element also, you normally go to edit cost element. Or even if you want to edit the one which is already created, normally you go to this edit cost element button here. Because your GL account and cost element are two different master data. Even the table levels are different. So in FI, the master data is GL, and in CO, the master data is cost element. Okay, so that is the purpose of this particular field, which was available, but which is not available now. Now the question is then why it is not available in SAP S4. Okay, the answer is in SAP S4HANA or in SAP Simple Finance, FI and CO were two different components till now. They are now merged to form a single component, which means you don't need a separate cost element to post into controlling. Whenever you post anything in the GL account, okay, this GL account is also considered as a cost element in controlling. So there is no separate master data for FI and CO. So your same GL account will be also considered as the cost element. Okay, so for example, whenever I'm creating a GL account, it will be automatically available for controlling postings also. So in short, GL account and cost element are now merged together to form one single master data instead of two different master data. That is the whole purpose of this story. Secondary cost elements, yes. So question is, we understood from the primary cost element perspective. Okay, so let me explain this also. Normally, when we are talking about cost element, there are two kind of cost elements in SAP. One is primary cost element. Primary cost element means where there is a corresponding GL account available in FI. But if you want to perform some adjustments only into controlling, which has nothing to do with FI. Okay, so for example, the cost is available in one cost center now. You want to move it from that cost center to another cost center. You don't want to touch your FI. It is only CO posting. So in that case, we make the use of secondary cost elements. Okay, so now the question is, if I'm not able to create the cost element separately, in that case, how can I create the secondary cost elements? Right? Primary will be automatically created because they are merged. What about secondary? The answer is, now going forward, secondary cost elements are also need to be created as a GL account. Okay, so even secondary cost elements are required to be created as GL accounts. Okay, any question till now? I will explain you, I will show you the GL account master data also, which will clarify your doubts. But as of now, do you have any question? Yeah, Majo, Suresh, any question here?
Yeah. Yeah, Gaurav, can you elaborate on secondary cost element?
Yes. Definition. Yes. Okay, let me explain with this example. Okay, so currently I'm in this GL account. This is ECC, right? Now, this is raw material consumption account, which means expense account. Okay, so normally what I was doing is I was creating a corresponding cost element also in order to post in controlling. For example, I want to book this consumption into one of the cost center. So if I want to post anything in the cost center, I need the cost element. Okay, so this I was creating as a cost element. Now, for example, when you posted on this cost element with cost center, let's say 1001. Okay, so cost element 40,000 or whatever it is, and cost center 1001. And later on, you realized that, oh, instead of 1001, actually this posting should be in 1002. It may be correction, or it may be at the end of the month, you are transferring the cost to the correct cost centers. Okay, so in that case, you may not need to touch this cost element directly, because anyway, the cost is booked into this, you just want to separate into the cost center, right? So during that time, we make the use of secondary cost elements. Secondary cost elements are something which is not going to impact your financials. Your financials will remain as it is. It will only impact in your controlling. Okay, so secondary cost element means which are specifically created for controlling. They will not post anything in FI.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so I'll show you this example here. Now, when we were creating the GL account earlier in SAP ECC, we were only providing the information like account group. Okay, based on this account groups, this number ranges were determined. Okay, I can give you one simple example. Let's say you want to segregate your balance sheet and profit and loss accounts. So you will create two different groups, balance sheet, profit and loss. Okay, so whatever balance sheet accounts will be created, they will be created under this group. And whatever profit and loss accounts will be created, they will be created under the separate account group. Okay, so whenever you create a profit and loss account, you need to tick this indicator that I'm creating this profit and loss account, and then only system will allow you to create a cost element, because you cannot create the cost element for balance sheet accounts. Okay, so earlier these were the options, either you select profit and loss or you select balance sheet account. But now if I show you here in S4HANA, if I go to, let me open another screen, and if I again go to transaction FS00, okay, so this is in SAP S4HANA. There is no balance sheet and profit and loss tick here. It has been replaced with this new field called as GL account type. And this GL account type, there are these four GL account types. So one is obviously balance sheet. Okay, profit and loss is now divided into two parts, primary cost or revenue and non-operating expense or income. Okay, and the third one, as I told you, secondary is available as a separate account type. So whenever you are creating a GL account, you need to tell the system whether it is a balance sheet account or it is a profit and loss. These two are profit and loss. I will tell you what is the difference between these two, but these two are profit and loss accounts. And third one is secondary cost. So this will be only required in case of secondary cost elements. Okay, these two will be required in case of expenses and revenues. Okay, and there is
still
no
the secondary account, yeah, still the secondary accounts have nothing to do with the financial posting, just for costing purpose only.
Exactly. So secondary cost, even in SAP S4HANA, has nothing to do with FI postings. Whatever postings will be done, they will be specific to CO. Okay, but there will be no difference in terms of how the postings are done. It will also generate the postings and postings now. Earlier, CO tables were completely different. They were independent of FI. Now, irrespective of whether you are posting a CO transaction or FI transaction, both will get impacted in one common table called as AC Doc. Okay, so that we will discuss in detail.
Thanks.
Okay, so anyways, we are going to talk about all these things in detail. Don't worry about at this point of time. My only concern was now, just remember that this field is not required because we don't have two separate components, FI and CO. Both are merged together to form one single component. Here on this, why that field is not there. So this is one change that we have seen till now in SAP S4HANA compared to SAP ECC. Clear? Any question? Dipen? Okay. What about Majo, Suresh? Any other questions you have here?
No, thanks.
Okay. So I'll proceed and save this chart of account. Okay, so I just created this chart of account as of now. There are more settings that you need to do before you assign this chart of account to your company code. Okay, so you can see, okay, maybe we can assign first and then we will go with the rest of the settings. These are again the same steps that we were doing in SAP ECC. So I'll go for assign. Here I need to assign my company code to chart of account. So till now we just created, we are still not assigned. So let's go for position. Company code SFIN will be assigned to chart of account SFIN. Okay, just one refresher for you. I think you already know what is this country chart of account and what is group chart of account. Okay, so I'll just give you the overview of this. So if I ask you how many chart of accounts can be assigned to the company code, what would be your answer? Three, is it correct? Three chart of accounts can be assigned to a company code. What do you think? Yeah, Majo, Suresh, What do you think? How many chart of accounts can be assigned to the company code?
Three.
Okay. Which three?
Operating, group chart of account, and country.
Yeah. So you mean operative chart of account, group chart of account, and country chart of account. Okay. So how many operative chart of accounts can be assigned to the company code? Can I assign multiple operative chart of accounts?
No, one.
Only one, right? Operative chart of account can be only one, because whatever GLs you are going to create, normally at the time of posting, you are only going to provide the GLs of operative chart of account, right? In addition to operative chart of account, whether you want to use group chart of account and country chart of account, that is optional. Okay, so group chart of account is assigned, I shown you in the last screen where we were creating the chart of account. There was a group chart of account field, which I kept blank as of now. And if you want country chart of account, that is normally assigned here. Okay. So we are not going to use that as of now, but the concept is same as in ECC. There is only one operative chart of account. In addition to operative chart of account, if you want group and country specific chart of account, those can be still assigned using the same transaction code. Okay. So I just assigned this company code to the chart of account now. Let's go back. Third one is create account groups or define account groups. So as I told you, when you create the GL account, it is asking you two things initially. It is asking you, you want to create this GL account under which type, whether it is a balance sheet or it is a profit and loss, or it is a secondary. And second thing it is asking is which account group. Okay, so this account group, why it is showing here? Because currently I'm talking about SL20, and SL20 is assigned to some other chart of account where all these groups are available. If I go for company code as FIN now, it will not show me anything because we are still not defined any account groups. Okay. So whatever account groups we define here, that will be available while creation of GL master data. Okay. So I'll click on new entries. Okay, so for our chart of account, which is as FIN, I just want to make it simple. I'm just using two account groups, one for balance sheet. Okay, and also I need to provide the number ranges. So my number will start from which number and it will end at with like the number range. I'm not saying the exact number, but my GL accounts, they should be within this range. So let's say 1 and 2. So I'm going to use 1. Starting with 1 means liability. Starting means 2, or starting with 2 means assets. So I'll say 1000. Okay, why? Because I assigned it 4 characters. Okay, so 1000 to 2999. In the same way, for same chart of account, which is SFIN, now I want to assign profit and loss. So I'll go for PL. This is profit and loss. Okay, and this one I want to reserve 3 for revenue and 4 for expenses. So 3000 to 4999. Okay, now what do you think? These two are sufficient. I'm also going to create GL accounts for secondary cost elements, which is neither the balance sheet nor the profit and loss. Okay, so that account group you will definitely need in addition to whatever account groups you are using. So for example, in your ECC today, you are already using hundreds of account groups. Okay, based on the customer's design, there can be the company who are only using 8 to 10 account groups. There can be the company who are using more than 300, 400 account groups also. Okay, now in addition to that, there will be definitely the account group required for secondary cost elements, because this was not required in SAP ECC. So I will create another third one here, which will be for secondary cost elements. Okay, so let's say secondary cost. Okay, and normally secondary cost elements we create by using 9. Okay, so starting with 9, again, there is no restriction, but this is normally what we follow in the industry. Okay, so these three are sufficient for our purpose. You can define the, or you can divide the balance sheet into 10, 15 if you want. You can divide by profit and loss also into different if you want, but these are sufficient for us. Okay, so this is creation of account groups. And the last step in defining the chart of account is define the retained earning account. Anyone who can tell me what is a retained earning account? I'll provide my chart of account here and I need to assign the retained earning account.
So at the year end, when the, all the calculations are done, so that whatever profit and loss balance, the remaining is transferred to the next year.
Okay, perfect. Yep. Any idea? Majo, Suresh, can you just answer this? What is retained earning account? Otherwise, I need to explain it.
That is for carry.
Yeah, sorry.
I think the end of the year, whatever balance is, either profit or loss, it is carried to the next year by closing this year.
Yes.
I think that is what retained.
Exactly. Anybody else? Hello. Maju?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, you were saying something or you want me to explain?
No. It's for carry forwarding the P&L and the balance sheet to the next year.
Okay, perfect. Okay, so maybe I'll again explain just to refresh. I think all of you know already. See, normally what we do, once we complete the year, okay, so definitely we are not going to start the new year from scratch. We already have, let's say for example, whatever bank balance we have currently in our accounts, okay, so we are not going to start everything from zero. That balance will be carried forwarded as the opening balance of that particular year, and then the debits and credits in the current year, and finally the cumulative balance. Okay, similarly, the assets that you have, or maybe whatever you need to recover from your customers, or whatever you need to pay to your vendors. So these assets and liabilities, you don't start everything from scratch in the new year. It is like you carry forward the balances and then you start doing debit and credit and the final balance. But when it comes to profit and loss accounts, okay, so profit and loss account, you don't want to carry forward. Profit and loss is whatever is for the particular year. Okay, you are not going to say, okay, how much profit I have made till now. Whenever you are creating your reports, you are talking about profit for the current year. Okay, so in that case, there is no point moving this profit and loss balances into the next year. Instead of that, you will be identifying what is the difference between profit and loss, which you can refer to as retained earning account. Okay, so retained earning is one type of asset which you are carrying forward. So whatever is the balance between profit and loss, that is in one single GL account, it is carried forwarded into the retained earning account. Okay, so that retained earning account you have to define here, which means how the system will know. For example, I have 10 different profit and loss accounts. How the system will know that I need to perform the calculation for this 10 GL accounts, and whatever balance is appearing, I need to transfer that into the retained earning account. That particular thing you are writing here. So normally we enter X year. I'll tell you what is this, and you need to specify in which account, in which retained earning account you want to transfer the balances. But since as of now, we don't have any GL account created for our chart of account, so I can skip this step. Okay, it will just throw me the, give me the warning message. Just say okay and go ahead. Okay, but definitely if you don't maintain this GL account afterwards, if you not maintain this GL account afterwards, it will throw error in future whenever you are trying to migrate the balances or whenever you are trying to carry forward the balances. Okay, so that is very important. Before you perform the carry forward, you need to maintain this GL account. So as of now, we can avoid this, but we will come again back to this transaction later on. Just give me a minute. Yeah, sorry. So which account to specify here? It is based on this X. What is this X? Why we have written X here? This is actually, if you remember, if you go to this GL item, okay, when you create this GL, maybe I'll show you one with existing GL. So let's go for this. Can you see this? You enter this X only in case of profit and loss accounts. If you select this balance sheet, there is no need of X. This means this GL will be part of all the calculation made within X. And when I say this X, X is assigned to the retained earning account. For example, you have 20 different profit and loss accounts. Okay. And you don't want to move all the balances in one retained earning account. You want two retained earning accounts. Possible, right? It depends upon your requirement. So how the system will know which GLs should be considered in retained earning one and which GLs will be considered in retained earning two account based on this. So you will create X and Y here. When you say X, whatever GLs are available in X, the calculation will be performed and it will be available in retained earning one. And whatever GLs you will assign to Y, that will go to retained earning two account. Okay. That is the reason we maintain this X or Y or whatever different combinations you have here. Normally, I think X is sufficient. We, in many companies which I worked, normally we use only one X is sufficient. But that is the whole purpose of this X and Y here. Okay, so now we have our chart of account properly configured, assigned to our company code. Any questions till now?
So the multiple profit and loss account of the current year, when they close, they carry out to the single retained account.
Exactly. True. So if you have hundreds or 200s of GL accounts, thousands of GL accounts are also possible in one of the company codes. So there is no point carrying forward all that profit and loss balances in each single GL account. So the calculation will be performed and only the remaining amount that will be transferred to the retained earning account. That is the whole purpose. And retained earning account, again, it is asset and liability account, balance sheet account. It is not a profit and loss account. So in short, we don't carry forward profit and loss accounts to the next year. We calculate the balance and it is transferred to the retained earning account. Clear, Suresh?
Yeah.
Okay. So this was about chart of account. So again, there is only one change related to that secondary GL account.